Thank you.
By the time he left, this was the whole lot turned out.
What's going on, guys?
Hello.
Holy water.
Holy
water. Gonna be holy water.
Soon to be holy water.
Hey Jim.
Uh-oh, there's trouble.
That'll be holy water when you leave.
Test.
Good evening, everybody. Honk if you can hear me. Honk if you can't hear me. Hey, good. Everybody can hear. All right, good. So thank you for joining us for our Pentecost parking lot prayer service. So this is an important feast in our church. We just finished, those of you who were here watching everybody leave church, we just finished celebrating the sacraments of initiation for those who were preparing to come into the church at Easter, but in these unusual times, we brought them into church on the Feast of Pentecost. So give a big honk for all the people who joined the church today. That's a big thing. And you'll notice I even have a special colorful mask that I wore for Pentecost, so nice and colorful with the Pentecost color, so I was in the spirit. So again, we want to welcome you to this Pentecost parking lot prayer service. So we have a little prayer service we're going to do first, a little blessing. All of you should have received holy water bottle when you entered church or entered the parking lot. We're going to bless that water, make it holy, so you can take that home with you and use it in special ways at your home. And then also, if there's any graduates here at the end of this prayer service, we're going to offer a blessing for graduates. But we're going to do a little Pentecost prayer service also, where we call upon the gifts of the Spirit. But let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So give me a honk of the Spirit there. There you go. So my friends, today we pray as followers of Jesus, asking God the Father to bless us and to send the Holy Spirit upon us. The Holy Spirit opens our minds to understand what is good and true, opens our hearts to love one another as Jesus taught us, and gives us the strength to follow Jesus, and comforts us with the knowledge that God is always with us. And so let us pray. God our Father, all that is good comes from you through Jesus your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit. Send upon us the Holy Spirit that we might pray now with one heart as your children. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to now have a gospel reading. Father Keith's going to read. Deacon Keith?
He got promoted.
I did not become a priest during the pandemic. The Lord be with you, with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we do hear different accounts in the scriptures about the Pentecost event, but one thing is for sure. At the Feast of Pentecost, the outpouring of the Holy Spirit came upon those first apostles so that they then had strength to go out and be the presence of Jesus for others and to spread the good news. And so that's what the Holy Spirit does for us. You know, in my homily this weekend, which you can still watch online, there's an online mass also, but in the masses that we're celebrating this weekend, one of the things that I talk about is that the Holy Spirit is what binds us together. We're bound to God and we're bound to one another through the power of the Spirit. And that Spirit gives us strength to do amazing things, to see the world differently, to recognize everyone as brothers and sisters. You know, our world today, you know, in this pandemic time we're living in, we hear about all the people who have lost lives. We hear about all the people who are sick and suffering. But for us, we can't just see them as a number. We have to see them as our brothers and sisters. All the people that are affected by racial hatred, all the violence and war and dehumanizing ways that people treat each other, we can't ever accept that because we are brothers and sisters through that power of the Holy Spirit. So our lives are different because of the gift of the Spirit. So we want to celebrate that today. Now, one of the things we also reminded of at the Feast of Pentecost is that our life in Christ began at baptism. That's when we first received the Spirit. And so as you came into the parking lot tonight, you received a holy water bottle. So what I invite you to do now is to hold that holy water bottle up high as we bless it. So raise it nice and high as we offer this special blessing. Would you hold this? May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son upon this water and make it holy. May this holy water remind us of our entry into life with Christ through our baptism and our call to use the gifts of the Holy Spirit to share the good news and bring the light, joy, and peace of Christ to others. So we ask you to bless this water, bless those who use it, and be with them always in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So use that holy water in special ways in your home. You can use it to bless yourself as you come and go, or bless rooms of your home, but use that as a special reminder of your life with Christ and that gift of the Spirit that came to you through your baptism. So today, as we call upon God the Father to send the same Holy Spirit among us, to come into our souls, to fill our hearts, and to change our lives, let us together pray for the gifts of the Spirit. So I'm going to call upon all the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, ask God to grant those to each of us. At the end of each one, I'll say amen, and you just repeat nice and loudly, amen, in response. So loving God, grant us the gift of piety so that we may serve you for the future with increased fervor, follow with more promptness your holy inspirations, and observe your divine precepts with greater fidelity. Amen.
Amen.
Grant us the gift of knowledge so that we may know the things of God and, enlightened by your holy teaching, may walk in the path of eternal salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Grant us the gift of fortitude and strength so that we may overcome courageously all the assaults of evil and all the dangers which threaten the salvation of our souls. Amen.
Amen.
Grant us the gift of counsel so that we may turn away from temptation and always choose what is more conducive to our spiritual advancement and growth. Amen.
Amen.
Grant us the gift of understanding so that we may apprehend the divine mysteries and through heavenly things detach our thoughts and affections from the vain and passing things of this world. Amen. Grant us the gift of wisdom so that we may rightly direct all our actions, referring them to God as our last end, so that having loved him and served him in this life, we may have the happiness of possessing him eternally in the next. Amen.
Amen.
And grant us the gift of fear of the Lord, so that we might understand the greatness and awesomeness of the Lord, so that we will want to serve the Lord because of who he is. Amen.
Amen.
And come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us in the same spirit to be truly wise and ever to rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're now going to offer a special blessing to graduates. If there are any graduates here with us, you're welcome to step out of your car if you'd like. But if you have any graduates in your family who aren't here, hold them in your heart. But we're going to offer this special blessing of graduates. So this has certainly been an unusual time for all those who have graduated at different levels. All the graduations are happening very differently, having to reimagine the way people end their school years. But we give thanks, though, for their patience and strength during this time, and we want to celebrate them. So let's extend a hand of blessing over the graduates who are here and all the graduates in our life. May God, who began this good work in you, carry it through to completion and enable you to use your gifts and talents to the fullest. May God give you the grace to make wise choices and give you purpose as you move on to the next steps in your life, always confident in his divine presence and in the support of those who love you. May God grant you courage and a commitment to justice so you may make a positive difference, seeing God in all things and all people. May God bless you with the strength to walk your new path in the footsteps of Jesus as modern-day disciples, knowing you can bring light and Christ's love to others. May your integrity be a gift to the world, and may the Spirit of God be with you always as you are guided to a future filled with bright hope and abundant blessings. And may Almighty God shower you with his blessing in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's give a big honk of support for our graduates. So our first talented parishioner sharing her gifts with us is Sharon Bradley. Sharon has been one of the mainstays of our annual Spaghetti Dinner Variety Show, so she offered to share a little talent with us tonight and tomorrow for our variety show. And so she's going to share a beautiful song with you. So let's give a big honk of support for Sharon.
We pray for blessings. We pray for peace. Comfort for family. Protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. And all the while, we hear each spoken need. As long as we have faith to blessings come through raindrops. What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? Your voice to hear. We cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness. We doubt your love. As if every promise from your words is not enough. And all the while, you blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? When friends betray us and darkness seems to win,
fitting for these times. So thank you very much, Sharon. She's very talented. Beautiful, beautiful song. So next up is John Baldwin. So many of you know him. He's been a regular in our music ministry, and so he's now going to share a song with us. So let's give a big round of honks for John. We are truly blessed here at Presentation to have such talent. That was beautiful, both by John and Sharon, so we're grateful for them. Now, if I said we saved the best for last, I'd be lying after Sharon and John performed, but our staff does have a little, it's more of a fun act to let you know how we feel about all of you. So thank you all for coming. Blessings to all of you. We're gonna get started. Our staff is ready to go. So just have fun with it. Don't laugh at us too much. But know that our love and support for all of you we miss you. So we love all of you. So we thank you for all that you do to make this such a tremendous parish. But this is just a way of showing how much we care about all of you. So God bless you all. Thanks for coming. And here we go. And watch Father Wolman's dance moves. He's got some good ones.
So glad she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Because I'm happy. Because I'm happy, I know you know what happiness is.
Last time I almost jumped the bull on it.